Welcome to our very first episode of Inside the Mind of Throne. I'm so excited to bring you guys this series. Something distracting you guys? Something different? I need to fix something? Is that better? You guys don't like Duck Cats? We good now? All right. We good. Anyways, now that all distractions are out the window, welcome to my new series, Inside the Mind of Throne. A series where I take you guys into a Madden 19 game with me and tell you guys about my adjustments, my play calling, what's exactly going on in my head as I am playing. Also, a quick side note, I really hope I don't run into Anna Sophia Robb while I've got this mustache, because I really don't like my chances with her if I do. Chances are already low enough. She can't see me like this. Anyways, before we get into the video, I wanted to say I'm giving away 5 offense and 5 defensive ebooks over on my Instagram. All you have to do is like this video, go follow my Instagram, and then comment on my most recent Instagram post to be entered into that giveaway. Also, I'm trying to hit 100 likes on this video. If we can smash that, that'd be incredible. I'll give you guys episode 2 of Inside the Mind of the Throne. And if you're liking what you're seeing, consider subscribing. If you're already subscribed, consider hitting the notification bell and commenting notification gang whenever there's a new upload. I would really, really appreciate that. I try to respond to all comments that you guys leave for me, and I'm so thankful you guys watch my videos. All right, that's enough of the intro. Thank you for sticking along with that. We're into the video now, and Inside the Mind of Thrones starts before we even get into the gameplay. So we're on our lineup screen, and thankfully in Ultimate Team, we're allowed to be able to tailor our team in a custom fashion to fit exactly how we want to play. It's one of my favorite things about Mutt, is I'm only capped by my coin total. Now still, if I'm playing Draft Champs, if I'm playing Regs, if I'm playing Salary Cap, I can still build my team and mold them around that, or mold my scheme around my team. However, in Mutt, I have every single opportunity to get players that exactly fit into my scheme. I'm not gonna go over my lineup, but just for instance, if I head over to the defensive side of the ball, it's important for you guys to realize that as growing Madden players, there's a difference between, for instance, right outside linebackers by position, you have Lawrence Taylor and Anthony Barr. They're both right outside linebackers. They're both the same overall. Both play very, very, very differently. Lawrence Taylor is a pass rusher. Most of you guys know this, but I'm not gonna put him in coverage ever, ever. And I'm gonna put Anthony Barr in coverage almost 100% of the time, because that's what he does best. Or I'm going to user him, because he's an incredible user as well. Knowing something like this, think about that. Apply it to your lineup. Use pass rushing outside linebackers at DNs if you're in a 4-3, or use pass rushing outside linebackers at outside linebackers if you're in a 3-4. Another instance, I have Deion Sanders starting at cornerback, but in game, I'll sub him into free safety because I man up my free safety all the time. And who better in man coverage than the best man coverage player in the game? Just a few instances. I'm not going to go over exactly why my lineup is the way it is, but I want you guys to know, hey, you've got the opportunity to build your team. It starts there. Build it the way that you play. Anyways, now we can get into the gameplay. All right, we're into a game. We're receiving first. I would say as a coach, obviously you want to kick first in Madden. With short quarters, you want to be able to have the ball at the end of the half. They call it double dipping the chip, scoring before half and then getting the ball right back. Setting audibles are crucial to being able to be successful in your certain formations that you're going to be running. You can do that by just coming to the formation, clicking left trigger, and you can replace your audibles. But anyways, first play of pretty much every single game, when I'm on offense, I like to come out in this play right here. It's called Saints Out. It's an incredible way to be able to hit the flat and have a high low on that side. I'm going to do that, hit my flat, and just take my yards to start the game. I want them to start playing hard flats and have to play more aggressively. I'm not going to let you sit there without hard flats or thinking that the flats can be left open all game. All I'm doing is I'm establishing a presence. I'm trying to give myself a nice first down to start this drive. And I noticed, hey, he was cover 3 last play. I think he's going to be cover 3 again. And guess what? I'm going to try to expose that. I've got a cover 3 beater. Am I going to be able to beat it? That's the question. I'm not going to be able to, but I've got a huge dot to Chris Carter right up the field, all the way across midfield to the 32-yard line. A perfect second down play right there. That's probably my best play I have. I know I went to it a little early, but I'm already into field goal range now, and that's worth it. I'm almost certain my opponent is in cover 3 again here. I've gone to fake screen wheel to try to hit him right up the seam, or... oh, hold up. Wow, that's hot, Tyreek Hill. I playmakered him with the right stick. I was able to roll out, gave myself a little bit of time. Not exactly what I tried to do on the play, but we gained a ton of yards. We're on a first and goal from the 5. The toughest spot on the field to score. I have high ball options at the slot. I have Ricky at halfback. I can just high ball right over. Boom, Chris Carter's going to come down with that thing. High balls are overpowered. Throw them in the red zone. Solid first drive. We're able to go out and go up 7-0. But I have no clue how his offense is. He may be an offensive wizard for all I know. We need to be able to come out and get a huge stop and put all the pressure on him. I'm going to play really aggressive on this drive. And then I'm going to run this fire zone 3 almost every single play, but I'm going to change up the way I run it every time. I do not want you to catch on to what I'm doing. I'm going to man up different people. I'm going to play hard flats. I'm going to change my coverage shell. I expect him to run a toss to the right here. He's in I-form close. It's a common play by problem right. Really common run play. He's going to run to the left. We're able to... Oh, wait, no, that's play action. I didn't even notice it. Who runs play action online? Anyways, a good dot by him. He caught me off guard. Give it to him. Semi-manned up the Jerry Rice ball that he just threw. And here it is. Play action again. He ran the same play. And I've got this picked off 100%. And the game sucks! Don't blame the game. Stay positive, okay? I'm not good at that. All right, I'm sending a bunch of heat at him here. I've got a flat on the right. Oh, we just hummed at him. I wanted to be aggressive on 2nd and 10, put him in a long situation for 3rd down, and I like that. And guess what? I'm going to do the same thing. I'm sending so much heat at him, he's not going to have a clue what to do. Here's what I'm doing. I'm sending tons of heat, and I've got to cover up the slot to the left side, okay? Right there, Jerry Rice. That's got to be mine if he throws that. I can't let him just throw up the slot. There it is. I'm coming back down, and I've got absolute screaming heat at him. Those long yardage situations, you don't want to give your opponent time to throw crossing patterns. Now, if I was your Madden coach, I'd tell you to run the ball in this situation. Unfortunately for you guys, I don't run the ball when I play Madden. I don't really ever. I'm a pretty firm believer in Madden was made to pass the ball. And I'm just going to dot you same exact post route. He was in cover two that time, though. I want one spin with Chris Carter. Same thing, 5 for 5, 103 yards. We're executing our game plan perfectly. He was cover 2. I feel like he might be cover 2 again. I don't know here. Yeah, it's cover 2 again. I could tell by the way his safeties came out right away. I'm almost certain it's cover 2. I'm going to block Ricky Williams, so I just have more time. I'm trying to hit Tyreek Hill. It's cover 3, actually. And I've actually got a perfect plan to scramble. I would say get down at their QB always, always slide. But Donovan McNabb hits the spin threshold. Idiot spin. I'm able to spin defenders really often. And right there looked like a pretty riskless spin, if I'm being honest. In this sort of situation, it's 2nd and 10. I'm up 7-0. I really want to make sure that I'm able to keep my field position to get this field goal. Because that gives me a 2-possession lead. When, keep in mind, I got ball first. He could double dip the chip right at half and be able to get the ball back to back and make up a lot of points in that manner. So I'm just going to check down here to Ricky Williams. He didn't have a flat on the left side. I saw him blitz off that side right away. Knew I was going to be able to throw to the flat. I'm coming to the same thing. 3rd and 2. Coming the same outs. I'm going to make you play hard flats. And when you do, I'm going to hit you over top with the out route. That's my plan, at least. Who knows how it'll go. Hopefully it'll go well. That's a hard flat. Like I said, boom. Chris Carter over top. And I keep my feet in, thankfully. I shouldn't have racked it. I should have possessioned it. But we're to the 8-yard line now. So 3s and 7s are the difference between winning and losing Madden games. I know I said I wanted to settle for 3 earlier. I will. Not going to throw anything too risky. But it's important to have really good plays for when you get in this area. And I know this play to Chris Carter gets open against every single coverage. What? I've thrown that ball on stream probably 200 times. And I don't think I've ever thrown a pick on it like that. His player just dove and picked it off through Chris Carter. Don't listen to me as a Madden coach, apparently. Holy crap. It's embarrassing. Okay, well, 7-0. Like I said, I wanted to be smart. I thought it was a smart play. Unfortunately, we have to get a stop here. He's tossing. Kind of like I said earlier, he'd probably be tossing out of this formation. Good Madden players recognize what types of plays are in certain formations. If I see an I-form that's really congested, it's I-form close, it's probably going to be a toss. 2nd and 9, I'm going to send heat again, kind of like I did earlier, and I'm also protecting for 4 verticals. I don't think he's in Patriots playbook because he... Yep, 4 verts right there. Just make a tackle. Okay. I don't think he's in Patriots playbook, so he won't have Pat Sale. I don't have to worry about defending that. Patriots playbook doesn't have I-form close, just FYI. My playbook, New Orleans, has I-form close. I'm going to play hard flats here again, too. I want to make him dot me, which he hasn't done yet. And boom, we're able to scream at him, cover everything. That's a bag. Likely going to be gun bunch again. Yeah, 1 running back, 1 tight end. I'm assuming gun bunch. It's not. It's a tight offset tight end. Yeah, it is. So he is in New Orleans Saints. That's good to know. I kind of figured he was, but... Oh, my goodness. That's a tough first down to give up. I feel like my opponent's gotten pretty lucky. I don't really feel too concerned about him driving on me. I'm going to sit in this 3-man blitz here. Cover 3 shell, cloud flats. I'll show it to you right there. with Ryan Shazier in the deep blue. And then I'm not manning up Dion. He's just going to be in a hook. It's a screen to the right side. Screens aren't very good in Madden, guys. I wouldn't run them ever, just FYI. Years past, yeah, sure. Now, I wouldn't run screens. So we just hit the two-minute warning. Again, he can double-dip the chip. It's crucial that I don't allow seven here. I have to make sure that he does not get in that end zone. He's going to come out to I-form close. Probably going to be a toss, if we're being honest. I'm pretty aggressive with my defense here. I'm playing hard flats both sides, and I manned up both people on the left in order to blow that up, and we got it. Third and short now. I'm playing hard flats. I mentioned it earlier. Short yardage situations, always going to be hard flats. And he's able to throw a wheel route past me. Shoot, man! I can't be giving that up. He's three tight ends now. He's probably going to run the ball, so I manned up both my outside cornerbacks. They play the run better if they're in man coverage. It's a weird thing in Madden. If you didn't know that, use it. It's really, really, really powerful. Man people up to get them to play the run better. Second and nine, I'm playing really aggressive defense. Only have one deep blue out on the field, but I really want this ball back before half. I feel like I can go get points pretty handily. And there we go. We scream at him. I'm calling a timeout. 38 seconds left. I have one more timeout. Perfect. I just have to hold him here and I get this ball back. I'm trying to get him to make a bad read here. I'm sending a ton of people. Normally I'd play pretty conservative. And there it is. I got him to make a bad read. And he gets bailed out. That's fine. All right, 7-3. I need to go and get at least 3 points here so I have that comfortable cushion heading into half because he gets ball. And he kicked off to Tyreek Hill. Oh, that's a mistake. That's going to be a mistake. Yeah, that's a mistake. That's a mistake. Bad spin. He's baseline pressing too. I feel like Thielen might beat him over on the right side. He might not retreat in time. He did. That's fine. Absolute missile to Chris Carter. I got him to miss a hit stick. Fight, Chris! Okay, 11, 10 seconds left. I've got a chance to be able to get 7 here. I'm not going to give that chance up here. I've got a chance. If I take a sack, whatever, it's fine. But this is such an easy shot to get 7. I'm going for a high ball to Chris Carter back of the end zone right here. Something I can get off quick, and I got it. Boom. Into that tender spot, we catch it. High balls again. Super powerful. Throw them, guys. They're really, really good. So in about every Madden game, probably 3 to 4 plays are going to define the game. That right there, those back-to-back plays, 100% will define this game. He just lost his one possession game by giving up 7 points and going down 2 possessions heading into half when he was going to get ball. He would have had a chance to take the lead there if he doesn't give up points, or at least doesn't give up 3. He would have had a shot to tie, and he just ruined it for himself there. He played really, really poor defense on the first play, and then the second one, I was already close to the end zone. What are you going to do? I threw a good ball. These sorts of situations, I really like to send a ton of heat at somebody. So I sent everybody at this guy, try to get him to make a mistake. I got the sack, it's fine. I'm just going to half. I don't want him to throw the ball really, really deep. I don't want him to have time to do that. So I called my defense early actually to start the second half. I hate doing it. I want to see what personnel my opponent's in, but I'm not going to waste a timeout in the second half because they are like gold, guys. You hang on to all 3 timeouts in the second half because that can win you a game. If your opponent has the ball, you can stop them at any time, and the clock will not run if you're able when you use all 3 timeouts. So you hang on to all of them. They're like gold. I'm sure you guys know that, but just critical. I'm not going to use a timeout in that situation. I have a cover 2 shell here. Actually, no, it's not a cover. He's going to throw this. I've got him picked, yeah. I'm holding Y to be able to trigger an animation. Madden really screwed me there. That's a few times now. Huh. Okay. That play really stinks because it's a pick and now he's into field goal range. I can't do anything about it. I've got to move on. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to dial up huge pressure here on these downs because 1 sack and he's out of field goal range. He's probably going to run the ball, but 1 sack and he is in trouble, man. He is in a lot of trouble. I'm going to play hard flats. Boom, good hit, Shaz. And same thing here. Third and short, playing man coverage across the board, and I am playing hard flats on the left side. I'm trying to get my opponent to take a sack. He had his read there. He didn't get it off. He's out of field goal range now. That's why I sent 6 people at him, was to try to get him to not be able to take a field goal right there, because now that'll preserve that 2-possession lead if I can get a stop here on 4th down. That was so critical. So I'm going to play clouds here. I'm protecting the sticks. Crucial down for me to do so. And then I'm blitzing Kraus off this left side. Something that looks a little bit like this. A nice little I didn't get to show you my coverage shell there. It was like cover two almost. And he throws a dot up the middle. I shouldn't have let him throw that. That was really bad of me. Oh my gosh. Still gonna be on Chaz here. Yeah, I played a hard flat. I knew he was going there. So here, I'm putting a ton of people in coverage. I'm just trying to prevent him from getting into the end zone. I don't care about trying to force a turnover necessarily. He's gonna throw this. Yeah. I thought there'd be a post on that side. Oh, okay. There it is. I forced the turnover. I was just trying to make sure he didn't get seven. I didn't feel like I could force a turnover there. Instead, he's really trying to get seven for some reason. We're able to make him pay for it. Great play on the alert. And he's in cover three here. I gotta be able to avoid this pass rush off the left side. And if I do, I could have a touchdown. Boom. Chris Carter. Get going, kid! I called the cover three. I called it. I did. That's a TD. Predictable defense. Be careful as an opponent. Remember, we're trying to be unpredictable on defense, not the opposite. Again, Clocks is enemy right here. That's why he's no huddling. That's why he's trying to hustle and call plays quickly. That's fine. I'm playing a little bit too aggressively for this situation even, but we got double crossers here. I'm going to go take that one, yeah. Deion's probably going to make a play. Make a play, Shaz! What a play by Barr in coverage there. Do you guys think LT makes that play? That's where we talk about putting players in coverage that are good in coverage, and Barr is certainly excellent. I can tell already this is cover two. I can guarantee it for you guys. 100% guaranteed. Got a cover two beater in the back pocket for this type of situation. I can throw it in between the safeties, fit it in, touchdown, Tyreek Hill. Came out. Just, you can tell it was cover two. I kind of expected it to be man coverage, and it was, but it's a lot easier to beat if it's not man coverage. Regardless, 28-3, you're kind of getting the gist of it, of my mindset throughout this game. Every single game, I don't have a clue how good my opponent is, so I'm going to treat it at the beginning of the game like he's a really skilled opponent. And I can tell pretty early, but there were certain things he gave me trouble with. I felt like a few times he threw into coverage where I didn't necessarily get lucky, but then again, I high-pointed him for a touchdown or two. Certainly has predictable defense, and his user's been nothing to be certainly scared of. Things my opponent could do better? I wouldn't ever try to throw out of I form if you don't have a really, really good run game that you're committed to, which he kind of showed he didn't. I wouldn't run out of I, or throw the ball out of I form. You're crippling yourself. There aren't many good pass plays. There aren't good route combinations. It's hard to pass protect out of I form. You're just putting yourself in a bad position. I'm actually going to manhunt Jerry Rice over there. Deion's definitely not getting over in that cover two shell from the center. Out route? Nope. Well, I don't get... Dude, I got beat on the stupid... Okay, he got cheated really badly. I got beat on a stupid wheel route again. Again, I got beat on it. That's something that hopefully you don't let somebody do all game. He did that three or four times. I didn't even see it coming. GG's to this opponent. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the game and are able to get a little bit of a feel for what exactly I'm thinking while I'm playing a Madden game. I know there's a lot of stuff to process. I can't tell you exactly who I'm manning up and everything that goes through my mind. A lot of it comes a little bit naturally from playing a lot of games of Madden, but regardless, something you're going to keep on getting better with, especially if you're intentionally getting better. Something I heard on a Cal Ripken commercial when I was growing up. Really weird place to get that quote, but whatever. Practice doesn't make perfect. It's that perfect practice makes perfect. So going on into games and intentionally trying to get better and learn from your mistakes and improve, recognize plays that you're facing, recognize what works against certain coverages, how to pick up blitzes, etc., your opponent's tendencies, that's what's going to make you a better Madden player. Also putting in time into your scheme, labbing it, being able to practice and staying within your comfort zone throughout a game, especially bigger games. If you're in your Super Bowl, staying within your scheme, certainly good. And that's why I offer offensive and defensive ebooks for you guys if you do need a scheme. I've got both of those. They're both linked in the description. Anyways, I hope you guys did enjoy. We're trying to hit 100 likes on this video. I had a lot of fun recording this. I love talking about what's going on in my head as I'm playing a Madden game. I just appreciate you guys showing all the support that you have on the channel lately. I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you guys in the next video.